Hi, I'm Angel. I'm a marketing director working in tech, and I spent the last few weeks in HubSpot learning how to craft the perfect email campaign. So let me show you what I've learned. This is How to HubSpot. Email marketing is still the ultimate secret weapon that any brand can leverage to connect with their audience and convert them into loyal fans. In fact, I actually think it's one of the most important marketing tools that you have. In this video, we'll unpack how to use HubSpot's email tool to effectively connect with your audience, promote your products and services, and ultimately increase your revenue. By the way, it's completely free to get started with HubSpot's email marketing tool, so if you want to follow along with this video, you can check it out in the link below. To connect with your audience, you first have to make sure you actually have an email list. HubSpot makes it incredibly easy with tools to help you collect customer information in an effective and organic way. For example, they have an amazing form builder tool that allows you to build both embedded forms as well as standalone forms. To get started with the forms tool, you just have to go into your side nav, go under the marketing tab, and head to forms. When you hit the Create Forms button, you'll be able to see that you have the embedded form and the standalone form. Embedded forms live on your website organically, and standalone forms actually act kind of like its own separate landing page. Let's build an embedded form today. You can either start with a blank template or use one of the pre-built templates that were designed with customer actions and the corresponding fields in mind. I think for today's purpose, the email signup template is perfect because it has the email fields as well as the name fields. When you actually get into the builder, you can see that even though you've chosen a template, you still have access to other fields that you may want to add to your form. I think just having the email fields as well as the name fields is perfect for my purpose, but what I am going to do is go into the first name field and make this field required as well. Setting your first name field as required can be really useful as a marketer because it means that you can actually use the customer data when you're personalizing your emails later on. Once you're happy with the fields of the form, you can head over to the Options tab, and that's going to let you choose what happens as soon as a customer submits the form. I think having a thank you message pop up is perfect, but you can also show a specific web page or redirect them somewhere else. Then moving on to the style of the form, which low-key is my favorite part. To do that, we just have to click over to the Style and Preview tab, and this is where you're really going to get to play around with the button colors, the fonts, to make sure that the form is really aligned with your brand. So if you scroll down to the Style section, we're going to align this with my brand. So the button color should be a nice, deep, bright blue color. I also don't love the Arial font personally, so I'm gonna go ahead and change it to Georgia. On this page, you can even customize the look and feel of your thank you message as well. So I don't want it to be as dark, so let's make it a lighter blue. This is already so much more aligned to my brand. There's honestly so much more that you can do with just this section of the tool, so make sure you go and poke around and just have fun with it. Another really cool tool that I discovered is that HubSpot actually allows you to include payment links directly on your form. To find that, we just have to head over to the Forms tab and scroll down to the Payment section. Just toggle that on, and then from there, you can include a payment link directly on your form, which is really good for a buy-in campaign or if you have a pre-order campaign. Everything in the Marketing Hub is connected, so it makes it effortless for you to start creating workflows step by step without having to worry about what's next. So to do that, you can head over to the Automation tab, and you can actually start creating the workflows from this screen. For example, you can send out a welcome email as soon as your customer submits the form to ensure that they have the best customer experience. And you can do that right here without having to navigate to a different tool. To do that, you just have to click the Send Email box, and then you can either select a pre-written email or you can craft one on the spot. Otherwise, if you want to create pop-ups, banners, slide-ins, or embedded call to actions, you can do that with the call to action tool. To find the call to action tool, you just have to head over to Marketing, and it'll be right under the Forms tool. Again, HubSpot has a ton of pre-made templates, which makes it super easy for you to launch a new call to action in a matter of minutes. Having HubSpot integrated to your website means that you as a marketer could create new customer flows without ever having to write a single line of code. Sticking with our newsletter example, they actually have a ton of great lead generation templates that you can choose from. HubSpot also makes it easy for you to target exactly how the call to action will be triggered. So if you head over to the Targeting tab, you can select between on button click, on page scroll, on exit intent, or even after an elapsed time. This means you can use the call to actions to address specific issues like offering them a discount when they're about to leave your site, or you can meet them at a specific point in the journey like offering them an ebook when they land on a certain page. This becomes super useful when considering your overall marketing and sales flow. For example, if I have a marketing agency, my email newsletter could be used to educate my customers on trends and best practices while also warming them up to my services. Since we're building out an entirely new campaign, we're going to start in the marketing tab and actually start with campaigns. From there, we're going to hit create campaign and start from template. And I think for a newsletter, the email drip campaign template is perfect. It'll give you a few options to fill out, like what is your campaign name? We're just going to call this email newsletter for marketing. You can then fill out the owner as well as the campaign start date and end date and leave some notes about the goal as well as your audience. When you're inside of the campaign, you can actually see that it gives you a step-by-step checklist on what you need to do to create a successful email drip campaign. So first, you want to start by setting up your workflow. Here, you can either select an existing workflow or create a new one. Since this is a new campaign, we're just going to create a new workflow from scratch. And then once your workflow is completed, you can go back to the campaigns and just connect it. When your workflow has been created, then you can move on to crafting the emails, aka the fun part. From here, you just have to click Add Asset and then Create Email. This will automatically take you into the email tool so you don't have to navigate there yourself. To create a new email, you just have to hit Create Email and then you'll see that it actually gives you three options. The regular emails are just your one-time standalone emails. Then we have automated emails, which are the emails that you're going to use within your workflow. And then we have the blog emails, which are going to be the emails that are tied to your blog posts. Since we are setting up a workflow, we're going to go into automated emails. I'm just going to use the welcome template as the very first email. So the email editor is going to be quite similar to what you see with forms or call to actions, and it's just going to be this easy to use drag and drop system. You can see all of the different elements that you can use on the left, and then in the center area is where you can go and edit your email. So if I wanted to change a logo, I just have to click the company logo and then replace it with my own logo. If you feel like the logo is looking too big, you can adjust its size in the sidebar. Okay, that looks pretty good. To start editing the text, you just have to click the text section. I've written up a welcome email to get us started. So this is where it starts to get really fun. HubSpot actually has AI features built right into their editor, which makes writing emails such a breeze. To use these AI features, you just have to highlight the text that you want to edit. So for example, I want to adjust the tone of my email. Click the little star symbol, and then you'll be able to change the tone, expand it, rewrite it, shorten it, meaning that even on days where you're not feeling creative, HubSpot will just do the work for you. So for my email, I would love to make it a little bit more friendly for marketers. So I'm gonna go up and change the tone to friendly. Once you click the tone that you want, HubSpot will start to generate some options for you. If you don't like the first option that they give, you can regenerate, or if you do, you can go ahead and insert it into your email. Another really useful tool is actually their personalized feature, which allows you to cater your email to your customers. But just a heads up, it is a Pro Plus feature. So if you go up to the personalize button, you can select different tokens, which allows you to target different aspects of your customer data. So for example, if I want to use the contact's name, I just have to go to contact, select their first name. Make sure you always include a fallback value just in case their name isn't there. And then that actually creates personalization to your email, so it feels like you're really connecting with your customers. If you want to add any other elements to your email, you can select them from the side nav and then just drag and drop them into your email. So for example, if I want to promote my products and services, I can do that. Then once you're happy with the email, you can actually preview it as a contact. And then once you've sent out your email, it's time to dive into your analytics. So when considering your analytics for your email marketing, there's really two tabs that you can look at. The first one is the Analyze tab, which looks at your email marketing channel as a whole. So you're getting stats like recipient engagement, deliverability, and most of your key metrics can be found here. The Health tab looks at your opportunities for growth and just ensures that you're actually landing in your customer's inbox every single time. So once you've sent out some emails, HubSpot will actually start to give you recommendations on what you can do to improve your email's health. It's really important to keep an eye on your email channel's health because this is what ensures that your email does not end up in your customer's junk or spam box. There's so much more that you can do with email marketing, like connect with your customers, launch products and services, and even drive traffic to other channels. But it all starts with making sure that you're able to create that email list, write engaging email campaigns, and making sure that you are optimizing based on your data. And don't forget, you can get these free HubSpot tools in the link below. Also, leave a comment down below and let us know what other features you want to learn about. I'm Angel, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.